Welcome to Fair Game. I'm Christine Leahy. My guest today is one of the most recognizable faces in the history of U.S. men's soccer. He was a member of both the 94. So you feel comfortable, which means you'll tell me anything.
Anything.
I want to know.
Anything America's about and, you know, freedom of expression and all that kind of stuff. But to me, because there were other tests that he gave that had nothing to do with cutting your hair or changing the way that you look. But he knew that that was going to show how much I wanted to be involved in the team. Opened up so many doors and opportunities on and off the field. Because the other part of it was you got to play well. The team did well. I kicked the ball. It went in the right direction every once in a while. As a performer, your costume is important. And the way that you looked, and I'm from an NB, to see the passion of Detroit kicking a ball. I knew that there was a kid on the other side of the world, in whatever country it is, village,
which is
fun.
Some crazy
no, it was fun. Yeah, there's a lot of crazy stuff that goes on in the Olympic Village. You know, all that professional part, you know, 20-somethings that are all jacked up and ready to go. I had no shoes on. And that's all I remember about Jennifer Capriati. I was like, what are you doing?
Give me the dirt.
No. I did not fall in love for a minute or two or at all or anything like that.
I it was
that because every 4 years we have the opportunity to go to a World Cup and in that platform show the world, but even more importantly, show our country that we have progressed, that we have evolved. And we completely wasted it. We finished last in the tournament. There was this incredible drama and infighting. I take plenty of them. And I've been asked about this so many times, and this applies to anything in life and players. Just because somebody is, as you know, just because somebody is good on camera as an athlete during a sports career doesn't necessarily mean that it translates. Just because somebody do that. And I made a lot of mistakes going forward. But, you know, you come in contact with people that are ultimately decision makers. And when it, life being in front offices helped shape me into the person that I am today.